Assalamu alaikum class 9, hopefully you all will be good. We are doing tenses, you know that. We have done all the tenses given in your grammar book. See, your grammar book. And last year we have done all translation about the tenses. See, present, indefinite tense, till, future, perfect, continuous tense. So all the tenses we have done, Urdu to English translation. So in my previous classes I have just done few exercises related to your tenses, how we put correct tense by reading the sentence. That was your activity. Now I want to revise all of the tenses, and I want you to revise present, indefinite, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous tense till here. It's on page number 83. See, it starts from page number 74 till 83. So all the exercises given on these pages, you have to learn it to your own. It is already done in your notebook. You have to just revise these tenses. It is not the extra work. It is just for your revision. And before starting it, I want you to revise all of the rules of the tenses again. I have discussed the rules, but I have made a chart. See, it's my 15th lecture. Lecture number 15. Today date is 7 July 2020. I have make a chart, tenses chart, and I have written the rule. What is important whenever we have to learn tense? Whenever we have to learn tense, we have to learn helping verb and the form of verb. If we are learning present indefinite tense, we should know what is the helping verb and the form of verb used in present indefinite tense. See how I made this chart. I draw four lines here. I have written indefinite, continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous tense. And see, I draw three lines on this sheet, and I write present, past, and future tense. So three tenses I have written, types of tenses, present, past, and future tense, and their classifications are written here, indefinite, continuous. So how you will learn it? It is indefinite, present indefinite tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, present perfect continuous tense. So you will learn it like this. And same, past indefinite tense, past continuous, past perfect, and past perfect continuous tense. Same, future indefinite tense, future continuous tense, future perfect, and future perfect continuous tense. So if we see it, it is all indefinite series, present, past, and future indefinite. So present continuous, past continuous, future continuous tense, present perfect tense, past perfect tense, and past perfect, future perfect tense. So it is all the series. And I have written one sentence, I change this one sentence into all other tenses by changing helping verb and the form of verb. Maine kuch bhi change nahi kiya, sentence same hai. Sir, just maine helping verb and the form of verb change karungi, to sentences change ho jayenge. We know we have positive, negative, and interrogative sentences. So I make, I just change these sentences to negative and interrogative. I write helping verb and the form of verb of indefinite, continuous, and all the tenses, all the 12 tenses. See how I done it. See the sentence. Aslam buys new clothes. So Aslam singular hai. So we put S with Aslam. Aslam buys new cloth. I just underline first verb. What form of verb we are using? Negative sentence, Aslam does not buy new clothes. When we make negative and we write does not. Agar singular noun ho to we write does not. You know that. Okay, we have Aslam singular noun, that's why I write does not, and I just write buy. Maine yahan S nahi lagaya. Jab hum does not lagayenge to hum form of verb ke saath S use nahi karte. Aslam does not buy new clothes. Now interrogative, does Aslam buy new clothes? It's easy for you if you just learn helping verb and the form of verb of each tense. You will learn all the tenses. Helping verb is do and does. We use helping verb do and does in this tense, and verb is first form of verb. See, buy is first form of verb. We just put S if we are make, if we have third person singular or we have singular noun. You know the rules. Next rule is Aslam. See, continues. Aslam is buying new clothes. So we write is MR as helping verb. Aslam is not buying new clothes. Is Aslam buying new clothes? We make question by writing helping verb first, then subject. Aslam, is Aslam buying new clothes? So helping verb is MR in continuous tense, and verb is present पार्टिसिपल और फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब प्लस आईएनजी, यानी फर्स्ट फॉर्म के साथ हमने आईएनजी लगाना है या हम इसको प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल बोलते हैं। असलम हैज़ बॉट न्यू क्लॉथ्स, असलम हैज़ नॉट बॉट न्यू क्लॉथ्स, हैज़ असलम बॉट न्यू क्लॉथ्स। सो हेल्पिंग वर्ब इज़ हैज़ एंड हैव। इफ़ वी हैव थर्ड पर्सन सिंगुलर और सिंगुलर नाउन वी राइट हैज़, अदरवाइज वी राइट हैव। यानी सिंगुलर अगर होगा तो हम उसके साथ हैज़ लगाएंगे, अगर थर्ड पर्सन सिंगुलर ही शी आ जाता है तो हम उसके साथ भी हैज़ लगाते हैं, अदरवाइज वी राइट हैव। सी हेल्पिंग वर्ब इज़ हैज़ एंड हैव। वर्ब इज़ पास्ट पार्टिसिपल थर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब, सो वी राइट थर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब इन परफेक्ट टेंस। असलम हैज़ बीन बाइंग न्यू क्लॉथ्स सिंस इवनिंग, सो इन परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूस टेंस टाइम पीरियड इज ऑल्सो गिवन। वी राइट हेल्पिंग वर्ब हैज़ नॉट बीन एंड हैव नॉट बीन, सेम प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल इज यूज्ड। असलम हैज़ बीन बाइंग न्यू क्लॉथ्स सिंस इवनिंग, असलम हैज़ आफ्टर हैज़ वी राइट नॉट, असलम हैज़ नॉट बीन बाइंग न्यू क्लॉथ्स सिंस इवनिंग, हैज़ असलम बीन buying new clothes since evening। So see all helping verb and the form of verb I have underlined, helping verb and form of verb is buying। So what is helping verb? Has been and have been, and verb is present participle, yani first form of verb plus ing use hoga। Agar hum generalize isko kare to jitne bhi indefinite series hain usme humne first form of verb hi lagani hai, jitni continuous yani present past and future continuous tense mein you will see that we will write present participle first form of verb plus ing hi aayegi। perfect mein hum third form of verb hi likhenge, so bought buy ki third form bought hai aur humne third form lagayi hai, jitne bhi perfect hai yani present ho past ho ya future ho isme humne third form of verb hi lagayenge, just helping verb change ho jayenge, isme humne ing form hi lagani hai yani present ho past ho future ho hamare paas ing form hi aayegi। और इंडेफिनेट सीरीज़ में हमने फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब ही लगानी है, चाहे वो प्रेजेंट हो पास्ट हो फ्यूचर हो। हियर वी आल्सो राइट आईएनजी फॉर्म, सो कॉन्टीन्यूस यहाँ भी आ रहा है, प्रेजेंट कॉन्टीन्यूस है, पास्ट है, फ्यूचर है या परफेक्ट कॉन्टीन्यूस सीरीज़ है, उसमें हमने पास्ट प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल ही लगाना है, फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ प्लस आईएनजी ही आएगी। परफेक्ट टेंस जब भी आएगा उसमें हमने थर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब ही लगानी है, और प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट टेंस में हमने फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब ही लगानी है। इफ़ यू लर्न अबाउट द सीरीज़ ऑफ प्रेजेंट पास्ट एंड फ्यूचर एंड आल्सो लर्न द हेल्पिंग वर्ब एंड द फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब ऑफ ईच, यू विल इजीली लर्न द टेंसेस, यू विल रिवाइज इट अगेन एंड अगेन, दिस स्टार्ट विल हेल्प यू टू लर्न द टेंसेस। सी पास्ट, असलम बॉट न्यू क्लॉथ्स, सो इन पॉजिटिव सेंटेंस ऑफ पास्ट इंडेफिनिट टेंस वी राइट सेकेंड फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब, यहाँ बहुत सेकेंड फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब है, वी राइट सेकेंड फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब इन पॉजिटिव सेंटेंस ऑफ पास्ट इंडेफिनिट टेंस। सिर्फ ये याद रखें कि जितने भी 12 टेंसेस हैं उनमें पास्ट इंडेफिनिट टेंस के पॉजिटिव सेंटेंस में हम सेकेंड फॉर्म लगाएंगे। असलम डिड नॉट बाय न्यू क्लॉथ्स, व्हेन वी मेक नेगेटिव वी राइट फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब, पॉजिटिव में हमने सेकेंड लगानी है, अदरवाइज वी विल राइट फर्स्ट फॉर्म, बाय इज़ फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब। Did Aslam buy new clothes? So we write did at first, then subject and buy. अब हमने first form ही लगाई है, जब हम did लगाते हैं तो हम first form ही लगाएंगे, सिर्फ positive sentence में second form लगेगी। Helping verb is did, verb second form of verb with positive and first form of verb with negative and interrogative sentences। Aslam was buying new clothes, so in continuous see we write helping verb was and were, वहाँ is एम आर थे, यहाँ was were होंगे, और हमने प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल यानी फर्स्ट फॉर्म प्लस आई एन जी ही लगानी है। असलम वाज नॉट बाइंग न्यू क्लॉथ्स, वाज असलम बाइंग न्यू क्लॉथ्स, हेल्पिंग वर्ब इज़ वाज एंड वर्ब, एंड वर्ब इज़ प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब प्लस आई एन जी। असलम इट्स परफेक्ट टेंस, पास्ट परफेक्ट टेंस। असलम हैड बॉट न्यू क्लॉथ्स, सो वी राइट हैड एंड थर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब। असलम हैड नॉट बॉट न्यू क्लॉथ्स, हैड असलम बॉट न्यू क्लॉथ्स, हेल्पिंग वर्ब इज़ हैड एंड verb is third form of verb and present participle। Aslam had been buying new clothes for 1 hour, so when we write the unfixed time we write for and had been buying, so we write helping verb had been and then present participle। Aslam had not been buying new clothes for 1 hour, had Aslam been buying new clothes for 1 hour, helping verb is had been and verb is प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल, यानी हमने इसमें प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल यूज़ करना है। future tense. Aslam will buy new clothes, so we write will and shall with I and we. We shall, we write shall, I or we के साथ हम shall लगाते हैं, otherwise we write will. Aslam will not buy new clothes. Will Aslam buy new clothes? See, helping verb is will and shall, and verb is first form of verb. See, future indefinite tense में भी first form of verb ही use कर रहे हैं. Aslam will be buying new clothes. अब यहाँ helping verb will be and shall be है. Aslam will be buying new clothes. Aslam will not be buying new clothes. Will Aslam be buying new clothes? Helping verb is will be and shall be. यानी helping verb will be and shall be. जब हम negative बनाते हैं तो will और shall के बाद not लगाएंगे. So will not be लगाएंगे, shall not be लगाएंगे. When we make interrogative, we write will, subject and then be. Will Aslam be buying new clothes? I hope you will understand. And we are writing present participle and first form of verb plus ing. See, Aslam will have bought new clothes. We write will have and shall have as helping verb and third form of verb. See, perfect tense, in perfect tense we write third form of verb or past participle. Aslam will not have bought new clothes. Will Aslam have bought new clothes? I have underlined all the helping verb in the form of verb. Helping verb is will have and shall have, and verb is third form of verb. Now, Aslam will have been buying new clothes since morning. Aslam will not have been buying new clothes since morning. Will Aslam have been buying new clothes since morning? So we write will have and will have been as helping verb. When we make negative, we write will not have been. Negative में हम will के बाद not लगाएंगे, will not have been. Same interrogative में हम will लगाएंगे, Aslam have been बाद में आएगा, यानी subject के बाद हम have been लिखेंगे. Will Aslam have been buying new clothes since morning? Helping verb is will, have been, shall have been, and present. Verb is present participle. We write verb present participle in this tense. I hope you have understand. You have to make a chart to your own. Try to write any sentence you want to write and change one sentence into all other sentences. You have to write positive sentence, negative interrogative sentence, same helping verb and the form of verb of each tense. It will help you to understand and learn all the rules of the tenses. We have 12 tenses. You should know the helping verb and the form of verb of all tenses. It will be a good help for you. So I want you to make it before you have to revise the tenses. Good luck, Allah Hafiz.